Until we found the village, we had suspected that the detectors were just props. Just toys given to us by the CIA guys to reassure us. Nobody trusted the spooks. But before we even saw the first hut, the needles on all the detectors started moving in unison. If they were phony toys, it was a cool little special effect. The needles swayed back and forth, and all the little metal boxes let out this spooky ooh-ah-ooh-ah-ooh-ah-ooh sound all in unison. Like a school choir. Very weird. We turned them off. As instructed, we treated every Vietnamese as combatants and killed them all. There wasn't any resistance, though. A few had weapons, but most were unarmed. None fought back. They didn't even run. They were just sitting around, lazing in the sun. We shot them where we found them. Grim work. Very weird. That probably spooked us out more than the detectors. It was like they were waiting to die. After clearing the village, we didn't know what to do. So we turned one of the detectors on and wandered around to see what was up. The detector started going nuts around one of the bigger huts in the middle of the village. We had already cleared it, but we went in again. There was a big altar inside with candles and Buddhas and gold signs with Dink Reitman shit. We figured maybe one of the Buddha statues was setting the detectors off, but no. The hut was very hot and muggy. Even by the incredibly humid standards of Vietnam, it was incredibly, incredibly humid in there. Even the Buddha statues were sweating. Their faces were literally coated with drops of moisture. Everybody noticed that there was something weird going with the air. There was something off about the pressure. So we just tossed everything. Picked all the shit up and tossed it out of the hut. Sure enough, when we picked up the big platform that held the altar, there was something under it. It was a pit made of flesh. Maybe 5 feet across and going down about 20 feet before curving out of sight. When I say made of flesh, I mean it looked like the inside of somebody's throat. Wet, reddish-looking flesh stuff. We had heard of them building tunnels, but this was where we really couldn't even understand what we were looking at. It was breathing. The flesh kind of rippled and this hot air came out. And it felt and smelled just like somebody breathing right out your face. Enough to make you sick. They told us we would know it when we saw it. Well, we saw it, and we knowed it. We radioed in the coordinates, and got the fuck out of there.